Hello, Zero K fans, and welcome to Nanolith at Dawn. I'm your host, Chad of Fury 333, with more exhibition matches this week. Gonna be starting out with Exploit vs. Raaar on Wanderlust. And this is a new Wanderlust because Moose's Loose went through a bunch of maps, including this one. Actually, all the maps I'm gonna be showing today are maps that were modified by Moose's Loose to look more detailed. Like all these little grass details and everything, it looks wonderful. So thank you, Moose's Loose, for doing that. It is gonna help a lot as the game gets wider release, which is gonna happen eventually. Anyway, let's get, hang on. Let's get this set up properly. All right. Sorry about that. Anyway, let's continue. Exploit going for the Spiderbot factory, while Raaar is going for the gunship plant. And Raaar with... of course, there it is. There's the commander upgrade. I was looking for that. That's the thing about... oh. People are... okay, Orphelius is complaining about the cliff textures. I guess that's a fair point. They are a bit stretched. Anyhow. I mean, it's kind of hard to do that actually properly in the way that Spring does maps, because the way Spring does maps, everything, like, it's like this, that you actually paint it from the top looking down, effectively, and then it naturally has a tendency to squish cliffs as a result, which kind of sucks. I suppose with detail texture, you can make up for that to an extent, but once again, you're still dealing with the fact that it's stretching with high elevation changes. Anyway, sorry, not ant, spider. So, exploit going for the Spiderbot factory, very quickly going for a bunch of fleas, going for the standard scouting setup, and Raaar going for the quick Banshee, but mainly going for the commander very rapidly. What is their commander upgrade set? Heat Ray. Heat Ray! That's not a weapon you see on commanders very often. And against spider bots, I don't see that working out too well either. I mean, for fleas, sure, but for everything else, not really. Exploit already going for the tarantula, which makes a lot of sense. And the tarantula, it's actually kind of expensive. This is something that's going to work in Raaar's favor if they time the attack right. Tarantulas are strong, but they are very expensive, which means that Exploit basically isn't expanding. That's 400 metal. That's approximately 5 metal extractors. It's like 5.5 metal extractors that are in this unit right now. Now, well, granted, obviously other military units would be built, but Raaar can just go around the map and start setting up their economy far stronger than Exploit. They are, however, going in for the harassment with the Banshee, which is not going to work out super well because, well, it's a tarantula. As soon as it sees the Banshee, it's going to go for it, and the Banshee has to hang around in order to fight. It's not like a rapier. If it was a rapier, I would change my tune, but it's a Banshee. It's not going to be able to sit there trying to poke at any of these metal, any of these wind generators or metal extractors or anything without getting itself killed. And it looks, is Raaar? Okay, Raaar appears to be trying to distract the tarantula, figuring that Exploit's going to just go after that one Banshee, and they're actually right, or right enough. The second Banshee here is basically, okay, not able to do much, but it is giving Exploit the runaround. But the problem is, I don't know what Raaar's plan is beyond this. Banshees are really not the option I would go for. Not against tarantulas. Like I said, if tarantulas are on the field, I would go for rapiers. Do hit and run attacks. I force them to really have to be mindful about where they set things up. At this point, Exploit has two tarantulas set up. They're basically safe. Like, tarantulas do 220 damage a missile. They do, it's one missile every couple seconds. So two tarantulas will take down any Banshee in two volleys, like inside of 4 seconds. And Banshees, for reference, their DPS is 51. Like, they're not going to be able to deal with a tarantula for sure. Not really going to be able to deal with anything. They're going to get wrecked. This is a mistake from Raaar. Raaar is coming in here. They're going to lose at least 2 or 3 Banshees for free. And that's all they have. And forced to run away, just fortunately for them, the tarantulas targeted different Banshees. But yeah, look at that. This is what I mean. There is no chance whatsoever that Raaar is going to be able to come in there with Banshees and start wrecking up the place. They will not survive long enough. They will have to sit there and fight. I don't understand the motivation for Banshees in this case. I mean, they are strong units. They can do a lot of damage if they are able to hang around and do that damage. But with two tarantulas there, they're not going to be able to do that. So Exploit basically is totally free to set up. They're just getting their normal ground army. Well, Flea Venom, which is actually not super normal as a ground army. I would go for Venom Hermit or possibly Venom Redback. Actually, Venom Redback would be quite strong against the Banshees, just as a double check. I mean, the Tarantulas are strong, but I would leave them at home. Venom Redback will at least give a riot unit in the middle of the field. But yeah, Venom Hermit is a common setup. Anyway, whatever ground armor they go for, which in this case appears to be Venom Flea. Really old school. Like, years ago old school setup. Spiders used to do this years ago, before the Redback was a thing, back when unit morphing was a thing. And that was the reason Redback became a thing, because then people realized that the only way you could make this work was to have warriors, which you morphed from glaives, which you morphed from fleas. Which is a really silly roundabout way of doing things, and so ultimately we just ended up with Redback, and that does the job a lot better. But no, in this case, Exploit is dedicated to that, and Raaar is switching over to Shieldbot Factory. Looks like they have some plans to get some bandits out of, and there's the Banshees coming in here, actually managing to get a few attacks in. Now, Exploit, do they have radar? They've got plenty of radar. No, wait, do they? Yeah, they have enough radar coverage. They know exactly where those Banshees are. There's nothing weird about that. Oops. There's nothing weird about they. Come on. They know where the Banshees are. They know what's going to happen. It's no big deal. The problem, however, though, is that the Shieldbots are going to be coming in eventually. Not actually that quickly. The Wasp doesn't have enough energy to work with. Raaar is super low on their energy economy. They need to build that up. I mean, I'll grant they were reclaiming, but still, Exploit's energy economy is far stronger. Exploit can easily use any reclaim they happen to get, and then they have a Weaver right here in case they need to push more build power into their factory. I mean, Exploit's actually in a strong economic position. They have most of the map so far. Their army isn't super great. This is going to be a bit tricky. I don't know why they're coming with the Venoms. I still feel like, Exploit, do you not realize the Spiderbot factory has more to it than Fleas and Venoms? I don't think they do. I think they think that Spiderbot is still just the Flea and Venom factory that it was 3 or 4 years ago. I don't understand why Exploit's not using the units that exist in the factory. Like, using a build order that's more recent than when I started playing this game in the first place. Like, that doesn't make any sense to me. Exploit would have this game if they built some Redbacks or Hermits. Either one doesn't matter. If they built Redbacks or Hermits, this game would be theirs. And I don't see anything. Okay, going for the Recluse at least. At least that was something that was used 3 years ago. I mean, Exploit plays more frequently than once every 3 years. They actually play reasonably frequently. I do like to check out how they're doing, because they've always been a player that I think they have a lot they could do well. They just never seem to perform as well as I expect, and they seem to be improving last time I checked, but this just seems like they aren't understanding what the matchups have become in the last 3 years, which doesn't make any sense, because they play reasonably. If it was someone who was an old hat Balanced Annihilation player from back before Spring got Lua support, then I could see why they would forget, oh yeah, this is a thing that exists. Like, these other units exist, and Exploit's commander goes down as well, which sucks for them. They have no storage anymore. They still have an economic advantage, though. That's the really annoying thing. They're ahead. By any reasonable metric, they're ahead. Their unit choice is the only weakness that's really crippling them right now. And okay, that's weird. But yeah, that's it. That is the only thing that's causing them any problems. If it weren't for that, they'd be fine. Oh. Okay, Orphelia's pointing out that Exploit hasn't really played Spiders much. I mean, fair enough. It just seems weird to me that you wouldn't know, or at least wouldn't check, oh hey, there's all these other units. Like, I don't know, for me, if I haven't played a factory before, back when I was learning the game, I went through and at least figured out, okay, these are the roles. I need this kind of unit. My opponent's using Raiders, I guess I'll get Riot units. Or my opponents are using Riots, I guess I'll get Skirmishers. I mean, that's not the safest way of going about it. It really depends from factory to factory, but basic, absolute basics of the game, just as a way of getting started up, that's not a bad way. Like, you could do worse. But Exploit doesn't even seem to be looking at the factory descriptions, or unit descriptions. And noting that there is a dedicated Riot unit, and there's a dedicated Assault unit, which the Hermit's been there forever, so I don't even know why they wouldn't know that. But at least they have Recklesses. That's giving them a lot to work with. They just need to have a position they can attack the main base from. And once they have that, okay, cool. I mean, like I said, economically, Exploit is so far ahead. At this point, the best thing they could do is Fact Switch. Raaar, on the other hand, I mean, Raaar is holding their own fine. Their commander is already level 5. Of course, that's how they play. That's the thing with Raaar is that, yeah, their base isn't in as good a position. Their economics, they leave something to be desired. Map control is lacking right now, but their commander is a level 5 commander with like 2 heat rays and the ability to repair itself and a bunch of HP. Like, Raaar's probably just going to be stomping on top of Exploit's base whenever they get the chance, because Exploit right now isn't using the economy they have. But Exploit is going for it! There's the assault, and that is not going to work out too well. Once again, the Venoms do not have enough firepower on their own to do anything. The Fleas can't survive long enough. That's why you use Redbacks or Recluses. Redbacks or Hermits. Or Recluses, even. Recluses would have been okay in that situation, but not Fleas. Fleas suck. Fleas only work well in a situation where they're able to basically be attacked, or to attack unopposed. With Venoms, they don't work well. Venoms and Fleas have anti-synergy. This is a long since known issue with Shieldbot Factory. Yeah, so at this point, Raaar, they've completely wrecked Exploit's setup. They have a caretaker up for reclaim. At this point, Raaar's economy should actually get to the point where it's, apart from the energy economy, ahead of Exploits or on par with it. They just need more energy. That's it. Seriously, Raaar, build more power plants. If you build more power plants, you will take this game. Because at this point, here's the counterattack. Raaar coming in with a bunch of Banshees over to the north. There's not a whole lot of resistance. There's a few Tarantulas. I think those are the only two Tarantulas that have been built thus far. And yes, they are. That is it. And Raaar's ground army is so much stronger. Finally, we get a Redback. Hello, Redback. Exploit. Realizing this is a thing you can build. Had they realized that 5 minutes earlier, they would have won by now. At this point, they're staring down a game-losing counterattack. Because seriously, the amount of forces that Raaar is bringing to bear here, I mean, the Redback's nice. The Redback helps. Raaar's already moved to Thugs. Thug and Outlaw. If they get a couple Rogues, that's probably going to be it. And then Raaar's commander as well, already at level 6, what is this now? Oh, just more speed. So, I mean, Raaar's commander now just going to walk in. Strider-class commander, walking into Exploit's base, nothing can be really done about it. There's like 2 Redbacks on the field, and Raaar's army is a big mess. Oh, it does have Rogues. Yeah, okay, so they're good. They got Rogues. They got everything they need. They got Rogues, they got Thugs, they got Outlaws. They can deal with this. Actually, the Thugs are the weak link because the Venoms don't care. I mean, the Venom Lightning Gun just damages the shield's loads. I think the Venom Lightning Gun damages shields 200? Yeah. 200 damage on the shields. Like, as if it was additional raw damage, because that's how it works. For those of you not familiar, status effects like Disarm, EMP, Slow, when they hit shields, they deal a third of the status damage to the shield directly. So they're quite effective against shields. And Raaar continuing to be set up in a position where they could just walk in with their commander and probably win. And so here we see Exploits finally got a decent army set up. They have the Hermits, they have the Recluses, they have the Redbacks. They don't have the economy. Their energy economy is great. They must have a fusion plant or two around here. But no, they just have a giant wind farm. Wow. 40 energy from that alone. But yeah, that's the thing. They've got that. But at the same time, they don't have metal economy. And Raaar just needs more energy. They have plenty of metal in storage. They just need one or two more power plants, and they will be completely set. I don't know why they aren't building more power plants. Like, seriously, Raaar, build more power plants. Do you want Icons' chat widget? The one that says make E all the time? That might help. Actually, Raaar's kind of falling apart now. Exploit's composition is working. This is what I mean. This is what I was talking about. Like, case in point. If Exploit had been doing that sooner, it would have gone far better for them. They wouldn't have lost most of the map in the process of the counterattack. The only thing Raaar doesn't have right now is a proper energy economy. And more speed. Okay, a lot more. They're going to get more servos every level. More HP, more speed. But yeah, Raaar just needs more energy. If they had more energy, they could use up the metal they have. I mean, at this point, they have 20 build power moving in here. Yeah. get another builder, a couple caretakers or something, or put this wasp back on here. I mean, just putting the wasp back on there would still help a ton. They would get rid of most of the excess. They just need to have more energy. I don't know what they're planning on doing. Like, what is RAAR focusing on right now? They're focusing on combat. Okay, that kind of makes sense. Except that their units are all split up anyway, so they need to get that sorted out first. Yeah, economically speaking, RAAR is still behind. Exploit is on par metal-wise, but production-wise, Exploit's production is... not still 20. They're just not accessing metal. Like, they're actually making use of their metal around the map. On the other hand, RAAR is not. And there's RAAR's commander. Wow! Holy crap! 8 high power... What is its speed? 72 elmos per second. Really? That's actually... I didn't realize that was that fast. I mean, I guess Glaive's like 100-something, but still. Holy crap, that is... that is quite the push. It's... there it is! RAAR's super fast commander. Yeah, bandits are 90. So it's just slightly slower than bandits. I think it's more so the animation doesn't quite match up to the speed, because it's meant for the weightier, slow default commander speed. Anyway, exploit coming here with the crab, which that'll help a bit. But man, that's still going to be tough in terms of weight and positioning, because now RAAR has got another batch of bandits and banshees over here to the north just to clean everything up. Like, sweeping it from the north and the crabs all the way to the south trying to break what RAAR had set up economically, which isn't a bad idea, but at this point, Exploit's army is kind of all over the place. They have the crab all the way down here. They have a few units over by their main base, sort of defending it. They haven't got much to deal with the Strider-class commander, and their economy is getting tanked hard. As it was, they had a lot of it relying on overdrive, but now, holy crap, they've got almost none of it left. This is a little embarrassing, honestly. Sorry about that. But yeah, so... this point, RAAR is just going to be able to sweep around. Like, this is... this is an economic victory dashed by poor unit choices. And Spiderbot has relatively straightforward unit choices. So, I don't know. It's... okay, not as straightforward as Clokey. Oh, sorry, as Shields. Clokey actually does not have straightforward unit choices. It looks like it does, but it kind of doesn't. And anyway, Exploit throwing in the towel. They had the economy. It was all set up. It was right there. And then they lost it. Yep. Oh well, that happens, I suppose. I mean, someone's doing that with their economy, then it'll just... oh, the heck? That was unexpected. Okay, anyway. So yeah, that was... that was that. Why did it quit like that? Whatever. We're having just weird technical problems today. So, next match is going to be between Vistritium and Julets on Vitra. So stay tuned for that. It'll be up in a couple moments.